Scotty, it's me, Kenny. The cute little three-year-old boy you used to babysit. What happened? I didn't turn out the way you expected. I'm not married to a man living in Key West, refurbing antiques for a living. I'm married to a woman. I have been for over 20 years. I have children. I played with dolls when I was at your house as a kid, because I was in a house full of girls. You didn't have trucks and army guys for me to play with. Also, I still don't like pea soup, and I still don't like Jell-O. But the great thing is, Scotty, I could afford to buy these things and just throw them out so no one else has to eat them. So when I'm done making this video, I'm going to throw these right in the garbage. Finally, Scotty, I want to wish you a very happy 80th birthday. Thank you for being you, and thank you for being a part of my life and making me who I am today. Happy birthday.
Happy 80th birthday, Annie Helen. We love you.
We love you. Happy 80th.
Happy birthday.
Hey, Nana. I just wanted to wish you a full moon happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Love you, Nana. Hope you have the best birthday, and we will see you that whole week. Love you.
Happy birthday, Annie Helen.
We just wanted to say happy birthday to you, and we hope you have a lovely day, and I hope you're taking care of yourself, and yes, have a wonderful birthday.
Mm-hmm.
That's weird.
Go.
Happy 80th birthday, Scotty. We love you.
Bye.
Say happy birthday, Scotty.
Happy birthday, Daddy.
Happy birthday, Scotty. We love you. Hope you have a really good day. Ooga booga.
Hey, Scotty Pooh. I miss you. It's Richie Pooh just reporting to you from Kirkwood, California. Happy 80th birthday, my friend. Couldn't have ever asked for a better neighbor and friend. I hope you're doing well. Miss you, love you, and I hope you have a fantastic 80th birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Scotty. Happy birthday to you. Hope you have a wonderful day, Scotty. I love you. Bye.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Scotty. Happy birthday to you.
And many more.
Hi, Scotty.
Hi, Scotty.
We love you, Scotty.
Love you, Scotty.
Tonight, hope you get some tonight. Hope you get some cake and ice cream. Hope you get some tonight.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
City Waterworks, what drink do you want?
Okay.
Got plenty of them.
Okay.
We're done.
Hi, I'm Ellen.
Happy 80th birthday.
Happy 80th birthday. Well done. I can't believe you got to 80 and you're only 80. But listen, as you can see, we're ready to head out for a wedding. But I hope you have an absolutely fantastic day with the rest of your family. I know you will. I know you'll smash it and have a great time. Good luck. Well done.
See you in August. See
you soon.
Happy. The best woman I've ever known alive. Happy 80th birthday, many more.
Happy birthday, Scotty. On behalf of the entire Grasso family, I want to wish you a very, very happy birthday. You're always happy and you bring happiness to so many people, including the entire Grasso family. So let me be their spokesperson and thank you for all the years you spent with us, all the love you shared with all of us, including offering 3-year-old Emily a wee cup of tea. And when I came home from my flight, she said, Mom, would you like a wee cup of tea? Oh, I cracked up and I still think of that little expression. Scotty, you fed them. And with my house, that was, I think, fairly easy with 5 boys and a girl. I mean, lunch could easily be peanut butter and jelly every day of the week when I wasn't here. or hot dogs or hamburgers or anything. And of course, my kids might have been a little unusual because they liked the white bratwursts. So you offered to boil up some white bratwursts, went to the freezer, took out the white bratwursts, put them in the water, and waited until they were ready. And when they were ready, we opened up the pot, and what did we have but a boiled banana. And I'm sure that bothers you to this day, but we laugh about it. And we thank you, Scotty. Hope you have the best birthday yet until next year. I know you've got lots of people giving you love and helping you blow out the candles. But remember the Grassos. We sure remember and love you. Happy birthday, Scotty. Bye now.
Hi, Scotty. Happy birthday. It's Emily Grasso saying happy birthday all the way from Denver, Colorado. I've been out here since 2017. I did my undergrad at Boulder and came home for 1 year and then came all the way back to Denver. I love being here, but I just wanted to jump on and wish you a happy birthday. I can still feel your pinches on my knee to this day if I ever misbehaved. And boy, did they leave a lasting impression. And I'm sure my mom, if she hasn't already wished you a happy birthday, would love to mention the story again about you making me what you thought were bratwursts from the freezer, and they turned out to be frozen bananas for banana bread. So she loves talking about that story and bringing that up. I hope you're doing well. I'm wishing you the best and happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Scotty, all the way from China. I hope your 80th is a marvelous time and this next decade just brings you so much more love and joy. Happy birthday. I wish I could be there.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday from Spain. Not so easy to put a hat on a little baby, but we've got some balloons and we're celebrating early, and we hope you have a great time. It would be great to be there and see you soon, hopefully. Bye bye. Say bye bye, Alexandra. Bye bye.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Auntie Helen. Hope you have a fabulous time. Do lots of drinking, dancing and celebrating. Miss and love you lots.
Don't do anything we wouldn't do.
Bye, love you.
Bye, love you.
Happy birthday, Nana, love you. I gotta blow out the candle. Hey, you wanna do mine?
You made it!
Happy birthday, Scotty! We want you to know that when we look at our lives and we think of the many blessings that we have, we consider you one of the biggest ones. We are so grateful for the time that we got to spend a lot with you when these people were little, and we are grateful to call you a friend now. We miss you so much. We can't wait to see you, and we hope you have as an amazing of a birthday as you are of a person.
Mm-hmm. And we love you so much, and we miss you, and we cannot wait until we see you again.
Not 39 anymore.
not 39 anymore. Okay. We love you, Scotty.
Love you.
Bye. Bye.
Happy birthday, Mom. I love you very much.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Nana. I love you.
Happy birthday, Scotty. And on this occasion, we'll play some pipes for you.
Happy birthday, Scotty. We've had a lot of good times, fun, and great stories. You know where all the bodies are buried. You were a true friend and lifesaver when I had to go to work. You reached out and helped watch Ken for me. Happy 80th.
Happy birthday, Scotty, from Conroe, Texas. I'm going to keep it short and sweet like you. Love you. Bye. Mwah.
Hi, Scotty. Making my own video for a happy birthday to you. You're the best mother-in-law a guy could have. And it appears like you span the generations, from the little kids to the old kids, everybody in between. Always like Scotty. So you have a good day. Happy birthday.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Mother-in-Law.
By the time you are watching this, we will all be together in sunny Florida celebrating your 80th birthday. It's hard to believe you're 80, especially since you had me convinced you were 29 for so many years. They say that daughters will grow up to be their moms. I used to dread that. But because of you, I have learned to love Scotland and everything Scottish, including mince and toddies, meat pies, fish and chips, Highland coos, Highland games, bagpipes, and especially men in kilts. But I still love you, honey.
Okay.
I've learned to love musicals like Brigadoon, West Side Story, South Pacific. Especially The Sound of Music. I love camping, and I have many fond memories from our childhood at Happy Acres. Because of you, I learned to love to sing and dance, and especially to laugh. I hope when I'm 80, I look as good as you do at your age, 80. And I hope that I still have as much fun as you do and continue to laugh as much as you do. I also hope that I have as many people around me that love me as much as you do. It's true what they say about daughters, and I know my daughters are now dreading it. But I have become you, and it's not such a bad thing. Is it? It's not so bad.
No.
I hope you have a great 80th birthday, Mom, and we love you. Cheers.
Cheers.
Happy 80th birthday, Scotty.
Happy birthday.
Sending love from California.
Hey, Scotty. Happy, happy birthday. I hope it's a great one. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. For everything you've done for my family, for me, babysitting us and going on that great trip to that campground you had. I had a lot of fun. Hope it's a good one.
Happy birthday, Scotty. We hope you have an amazing day and an incredible year.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Scotty. Happy birthday to you. Oh, there you go. All right. Happy birthday, Scotty.
Happy birthday, Annie Helen. Happy 80th.
Sorry, everybody's not here. It's just me and the little guy. Hey, say happy birthday. He doesn't speak yet. Anyway, I hope you have a wonderful day. We love you. Miss you dearly. I'll see you soon. Bye.
Hi, Scotty. Happy birthday wishes from Belfast. 80 years young. Have the best day ever. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Hello, Scotty. I'm wishing you an amazing day and a happy birthday. I was going to come on here and make fun a little bit of Tina a little bit after watching her knowledge on how to take a video on a phone, but I'm going to leave that be for now because I'm not sure she'll remember the video itself. Scotty, I hope you have an amazing birthday. Go have fun, kiddo. Bye.
Happy birthday, Nana. We love you.
Try again.
Scotty Scroll Studios, where our motto is, if it's not Scottish, it's crap. Hey, Helen. Scotty, how are you? Understand you're celebrating 80 years. Wow. You've got 20 years on me. Just wanted to wish you a happy 80th. Also tell you how much I enjoyed our time together from 1981 to 1986. Great times there at Scotty Scroll Studio at 53 West Jackson in the 16th floor in Suite 1650 in the Monadnock building. Had some good times. Great lunches from Bonavino every Friday, whether it was a jumbo shrimp. But we had a good time, and certainly know how much my mom and dad cherished your friendship and vice versa. So I'll leave you with a toast. So I've got a bit of Macallan here. And may I tell you, Lang mei yr rumbrik, which means, obviously, it's long may your chimney burn. God bless you and many more.
Hi, Aunt Ellen. Hope you have a very happy 80th birthday and have a good day. Happy birthday.
Good morning, Helen. Scotty, happy birthday to you, young lassie. Wishing you all the best and enjoying a great day. I look forward to seeing you in mid-June, June 18th, June 19th, I believe. Okay, so that got cut off because I'm not too techie anyway. So just wanted to extend my love, my appreciation for you over the years. Always had fond memories. And again, thank you for being such a big part of my life and my family's life. God bless you. All the best.
Happy birthday, Auntie Helen.
Happy birthday, Auntie Helen. Hope you have a great day.
Happy birthday, Helen.
Love you.
Happy birthday, Scotty. We always have fun playing with you. You're the best babysitter. We love you.
Hello, Auntie Helen. It's the small, medium, large, all the way from Glasgow. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Sending you all my love all the way from Bonnie, Glasgow. Cannot wait till you and the family come over again, and I'm hoping that I could get over some time myself. I hope that you have a fantastic time, and I'm not even having to guess, that you've been spoilt rotten. And I hope that you like all your little videos. I'm sending you all my love. I wish I could have had the kids with me here today. I'll send you the love from them, their happy birthday. They're with their father just now, and yeah, sending you all my love. Mwah!
From 80, maybe 87 or 88, maybe 89 with your teeth out, but I never would have figured you were 90. You look great. Anyway, happy 80th birthday. And I just want to say that I'll probably say the three things that almost everybody who knows you would know about you. The first one is that you love to laugh, whether there's anything funny happening or not. We've all walked in on you in a room just sitting there laughing by yourself, which is a lovely trait. Number two is that you love, love, love kids. Not your own so much, but other people's kids. You just love. I think you had kids, I don't recall, but I think there was maybe one, a boy as I recall. Anyway, we met in 1974 at BC Castle Company, and I remember your first day of work. I didn't work there then, but the story was that John Perez, and Carol went to the same church that you went to, and he knew that you were going through a divorce, and you had three little girls, and he hired you to be the secretary receptionist. And your first day at the office, you walked in, pointed at the typewriter, and said, "What's that?" And so in the 4 years that I worked there, I don't believe you ever did figure out what that was, but it was a great paperweight. So two of the things I've already said that everybody would remember about you, but I'm not going to tell you the third one till the end. But I will tell you one story that I remember fondly, and that is, oh, and you did have three kids, I remember. When I met you, Carrie was about three or four. Eileen was, what, five or six. That made Tina, what, 40? I forget. Anyway, good kids, all. Anyway, one day we'd saved up enough money in the studio to take John and Carol out for their anniversary. And we had 25 silver dollars to give them. I don't know how long they'd been married. Anyway, we took them up to the Holiday Inn revolving restaurant on Lakeshore Drive. And we sat down, all of us there. And somehow Carol, who, unless she was around us, wasn't much of a drinker, but like so many people, she seemed to take it up. And she started talking about the 12 stations of the cross, because one or the other of them was painting something for the church about the 12 stations of the cross. And she got to about eight, and it was going on and on and on. And the restaurant had gone past the buildings and the lake and the buildings and the lake again. And all of a sudden she goes, "Is the room moving?" And I said, "No. No, Carol, that would be impossible, because think of the plumbing. It would have to go around this thing." And you kicked me under the table, so we went to the bathroom. And when we came back out, you were ahead of me about, oh, I don't know, about 8 feet. And seemed to know everybody. Everybody was getting your attention. And then I realized you had something dragging behind you. And I was hoping it was toilet paper and not a feminine hygiene product or anything like that. And I kept trying to like jump on it and stop it and get it off you. And I couldn't. I kept hopping at you till we got almost to the table. And I finally did stomp on it, and I held it up, and it was your bra. It had gone down through your pantyhose and out your shoe somehow, and it was dragging out behind you. So anyway, it was a very fond memory. And another one I would say would be the time we went over to National District Attorney's to pick up some certificates. And we were sitting there in my little Carmen Ghia, my little yellow Carmen Ghia convertible. It was Friday after work, and we're sitting out there at summer. And all of a sudden, I saw one of those double garage door freight doors start to go up, and I just jumped out of the car, didn't even open the door, just jumped out and ran, and it was about 8 feet in the air, and I leapt up and got a hold of it, and it was going up and up and up, and you were laughing so hard. Jim came out, I think it was Jim, I forget his name, it's her husband, and he started banging on some buttons and everything, so I was going like this up and down the thing, and I got up with my feet about 15 feet off the ground, and you just hollered, "Jump! You're gonna cut off your wee nubbies!" I don't know what they were, but it didn't happen. So anyway, we were always having a good time. And the third thing that anybody who knows you well would remember about you, and that is that it is impossible to walk down the sidewalk with you in a straight line. That if you're walking with you on the sidewalk, you're either going to get abrasions on one shoulder from scraping against buildings, or you're going to get herded into traffic and possibly maimed or killed. But anyway, I have a couple more stories, but you'll have to come to Maine to hear them. So, happy birthday. I love you. Bye-bye.
Hey, Scotty. It's Dave Monty. Miss you so much, and just wanted to wish you a happy 80th birthday and tell you how much I love you, and want to thank you for being such a great friend, you know, to my mom and dad, and a great mom, you know, to Tina and Eileen and Carrie and me and Joe, and you know, we were surrounded with love, and I'm forever fortunate, forever blessed, and forever thankful. So hope you have a wonderful 80th birthday, and I'll have a toast to Johnny Walker for you, and anyway, love you and happy 80th.
Hi, Helen. This is Jeanette from Glasgow, your cousin. Just wishing you a happy 80th birthday. Hope you have a lovely time. And I'll pass you on to Pat now so you can wish your birthday.
Hi, Helen. Yeah, we just want to say have a fantastic 80th birthday celebration. And hope to see you back here sometime. So just have a lovely time. Great memories. Bye now.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye from Glasgow.
Happy birthday, Auntie Helen. Miss you.
Well, it's early Saturday morning. What's the date? Oh, May 21st. I'm trying to get this video in for Scotty. Her kids are driving me crazy to get it done. So first and foremost, I want to wish you the happiest birthday ever. I can't believe you're so much older than me. Also, I'd just like to say thanks for so many good times in my life. You know, just a few. Going to the restaurant and sneaking out without paying. That was so much fun. We laughed so hard. And then, do you remember when we went downtown and we stood in front of the restaurant window and we acted like we were starving and we were rubbing our stomachs to the people that were eating? And I don't know if you remember this, going up to Jim's place, and we were, somebody was looking with a telescope in the next high rise, and I can't remember if we pulled our pants down and showed them our butt, but anyway, that was fun as well. I love you so much. I mean, I've known you for, gosh, 40 some years. I love that, you know, our kids are still friends. You know, we did grow apart, but it's still, we're friends. And I just wanted to say happy, happy birthday, happy, happy birthday, happy birthday. And you guys, don't make fun of my videos. It took me, you know, a while to sit down here and do this. I don't want to do it too long. Just again, happy birthday, Scotty. I love you. Bye.
Hi, Scotty. It's Anne coming to you from sunny South Carolina. Cheers. Have a wonderful day on your birthday. I hope we can get together soon. I miss you. Take care. Bye.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, Scotty.
Happy birthday, Scotty. Love you.
Scotty, when I was asked to be part of this video collage created for your special day, I felt incredibly honored to be included with your family. I definitely love you like family and wish you such a happy 80th birthday. Here we are 45 years later. I just turned 50 myself, and I've known you for 45 years, and remember back when I was 5 and you pulled that quesadilla out of my hand and ate it yourself. And so those were fun times, and I have such fun memories of living next to your family, and wish you the happiest birthday. May you have many, many more. Love you.
Happy birthday, Scotty.
We just want to say have the best birthday ever, and we're wishing you many more adventures in the future. We love you.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers.
Say happy 80th birthday, Scotty.
Happy 80th birthday, Scotty.
Happy birthday, Mom. Just wanted to make sure we have all of our family in here. Dave wanted to make sure to get something in for you. And our dogs, of course. Oh, it's June and Wrigley. All right, I'm going to make my own video as well because I want to make sure to get some memories in there from us growing up.
Okay? I'll add a memory right now. The first time we met, we was at Highland Games, and you and I stacked about, oh, I don't know, 35 pint cups up in the center of the table while Carrie was working. And she was She was mortified, so that was pretty funny.
It was fun.
Enjoy your day.
Hi, Mother. Just wishing you a happy 80th birthday. Hard to believe you're 80, or going to be, but you seem to still have the energy of a 12-year-old. Maybe that's because of Jack keeping you young with all that four-wheeling out there. But just wanted to say thanks for everything, you know, as far as growing up. We had some crazy times, but I wouldn't give it up. You know, all the camping at Happy Acres, that was great. Always including my friend Jenny. I know that we would get in trouble sometimes, but you always put up with us. Sometimes you would drop us off on a back road and just leave us there standing, and we didn't quite know what to do. But you'd always come back to get us, even if it was like half hour later. But other than that, you know, just going into the city with you all the time when I was growing up on the L, you know, eating at this fancy fish place and going to the water tower, things like that. It was just a lot of fun. You used to let me go to State Street and Michigan Avenue to check it out on my own. The one time I was almost kidnapped down there, Underground L, you beat the crap out of the guy with your purse until he took off. So that was pretty impressive. You're a strong mom. Let's see, I had some other crazy experiences with the Highland Games. Of course, you meeting Dave while I was working. And that was, and of course, when I was younger and you slamming my hand in the car door and all those bagpipers were jumping the ropes and trying to hand me whiskey. I think I was about 10, but you were grabbing all that whiskey and drinking it just to make yourself calm down, which is probably for the best. But anyway, I just, you know, you were always the life of the party, the life of the block. Everywhere we lived, everybody knew each other because of you. Everyone that knows you, all my friends, they all love you. I'll think you're crazy, but everyone loves you, including me. Thank you again for always being a wonderful grandma, as far as, you know, taking care of the kids when I really needed it. They love you, adore you, so do I. And look forward to many more years of celebrating birthdays. Bye.
Nana, after 80 years, you're still one hot dog. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you.